Hey everybody, so I'm Kim Button with GetGreenBeWell.com. I am here showing you what a cortisol saliva test kit is like. And why might you be doing a cortisol saliva test kit if you're having some hormonal issues like I am, unfortunately? Your doctor might request a lab work, seeing what your cortisol levels are throughout the day and how that can affect a variety of hormones, not just your adrenal hormones or estrogen or testosterone, but all kinds of things, insulin, everything else. And your cortisol should be peaked at early morning, and then it should go down a little bit, you know, gradually throughout the day. And so what your doctor is gonna ask you to do is just do a spit test. And you do this 4 times in one day, and you have little vials, little vials like this, and they are color-coded. This is one of the colors. And generally, according to my directions for this one, you're gonna have 4 different times. And it is gonna be right when you wake up, about 7 to 8 a.m. It's gonna be about 11 to 12. Then again, 4 to 5. And then right before you go to sleep, about 10 to 12. And so all you have to do, I mean, this is like one of the simplest, most non-invasive tests ever. You take the tube. You're not supposed to have eaten or drinking 2 hours beforehand, and rinse your mouth out with water 15 minutes before. And then once that you're done, you're good to go, you just start spitting. Like literally, you just keep spitting and until it fills up. It doesn't really take as long as you might think. Then you just label it, put on the time of day, and color code it according to what you need. Put it in the refrigerator if you need to store it for a little bit. Otherwise, you're just gonna put it into a biohazard bag. Usually there's gonna be prepaid postage for like FedEx or UPS or whatever your lab work is using. You just drop it in and you're done. I mean, really, it is nothing to be concerned about. What I do want to be sure to let you know, though, is if you are a female taking this cortisol test, it is gonna have to be specifically timed to a specific time in your cycle. And for me right now, it's days 19 through 21. So if you're having hormone problems, if you are thinking you might be going to a doctor to talk about it, it is extremely important for many reasons to keep track of your cycle, what day things start on, and then how long. And then you're from that first day that your period starts, then you're gonna count from then, that's day one, and you're gonna be doing tests according to portions of your cycle that are going on. So again, if you think you're having hormonal problems, if you're gonna go talk to a doctor about anything going on, you really, really, really need to start keeping track of that right now. But if your doctor prescribes a cortisol test, no big deal. Just a little spitting in a tube, you can do that. And it's all good. And then you'll finally see what is going on in your body as far as your stress levels with the cortisol hormone. So until next time, take care, be blessed. Everybody have a great day. Bye-bye.